This is my first Altoids kit, in fact my most compact kit ever. And this is not a survival kit. This is designed to help solve problems and reduce friction in everyday life. And I'm amazed at what I've managed to fit in here. There are lots of Altoids kits on YouTube and most are survival kits, and this is not one of those. And to be honest, if I did plan to carry a survival kit, I'd probably go for something a bit bigger. So there's no fishing kit or signalling mirror, whistle or compass in here. This is more about solving problems on the go, not in extreme conditions, but in day-to-day life. And as such, it's meant to have wider appeal and offer genuine practicality. In the lid, we have two types of tape. First of all, we have this, which is called self-amalgamating tape. And as you can see, it's low adhesion and it has here a backing tape. And once you remove that backing tape, this then stretches and that allows you to wrap it around whatever it is you're working on. And then it amalgamates with itself. And this can be used to seal damaged cables for protection and to keep the moisture out. It can also be used as a temporary fix to stop a leak on a pipe. And this could be a fuel leak on a car or a pipe at home, and it stretches and sticks to itself. So if the pipe was wet or a little bit greasy, it's generally not going to be a problem. Underneath the self-amalgamating tape, we have two strips of Gorilla Tape, and you'll see I've folded the end back on itself here, and that's so you can grab this easily as it gets super sticky. And this is great for holding things together or in place or for patching things. And I snagged a down jacket recently on barbed wire, and with the down starting to escape from a half inch tear, tape was the perfect temporary fix. This is from a company called Leathergear, and it's actually a charging cable for my phone, and it comes as part of a mini cable kit with a variety of connection options, but I just separated out the basic USB-A to Lightning part, and this gives me a very compact charging cable. And I did look very hard at everything else out there, and even the very short charging cables are way too bulky for this kit, so this turned out to be ideal. So this is designed to help when your phone battery unexpectedly runs out of charge, which can become a big problem. And with this, you still obviously need a charging source. Unfortunately, there's just no space in here for a power bank. But if you find yourself on a train or a plane or in some coffee shops or other public spaces, then a USB socket can often be found. And that is the reason I went for USB-A over USB-C, which haven't caught up in most public spaces yet. Next, we have four tie wraps or zip ties, and I've cut them short to fit in the tin and also to reduce bulk to a minimum and keep everything neat. They are held in place using heat shrink tubing. Now, these are great for emergency zip pulls or for tidying cables or for locking that suitcase zip when you've forgot to bring along your mini padlock, and generally useful for holding things together. Then we have a pen, and even though this is used for emergencies, I wanted it to be properly usable, and obviously the pen has to fit in here. This is the Minimo Pen. It's a perfect fit for this tin, and it's long enough to be comfortable to write with, and it also takes a standard D1 refill. Has a retractable mechanism and is ideal for unexpected writing tasks like form filling or noting down phone numbers or license plates or simply leaving messages. Some cordage is always worth carrying, but even the micro cord I've used before got a bit bulky for this kit. So instead, I've switched to Dyneema thread, which happens to be the world's strongest fibre. And this is very compact and very strong with an incredible 130-pound breaking strain. Now, in the kit, I have 10 feet of it in here, and it's contained within some heat shrink tubing just to keep it tidy. And you would use this where you might need strings. So things like binding and fastening, emergency shoelaces or a temporary clothes drying line when on your travels, and of course, a million other things. Next in here, we have a knife, and I was keen for this to be properly useful, but it needed to be very slim for it to fit in here. And it turns out this Victorinox Alox Bantam is a perfect fit fit for this kit. It's just 6 millimeters or 1/4 inch thick, but with a decent length 2-inch blade. And it is effectively a single layer Victorinox, but because the blade is slightly offset, it allows for the inclusion of this combination tool. And here we have a flathead screwdriver and a 2D Phillips screwdriver on the end. Also doubles up as a pry bar, along with a bottle opener and a wire stripper. As well as general cutting tasks, this blade size is ideal for cutting up food such as an apple or perhaps a cake when out and about. Now, this knife sits at the top of the tin for instant access, as this is one of the most useful tools in here, especially if you don't routinely carry a pocket knife. I've dropped in here a small ferro rod from a company called Tortoise Gear, and this is designed to replace a toothpick in a Victorinox, which is why it's so small. And this is a backup fire starting device for this kit, and I managed to include it because there was room for it. Now, we do in fact have a lighter in here, which is a much more practical option for fire lighting, but I have to say this ferro rod does work really well, particularly with the wire stripper in the Victorinox. Next, we have this high density magnet, which although very small is also very strong, and this is for use with the Dyneema thread to enable magnet fishing. And if you've ever dropped your keys down an unreachable gap, perhaps in your car like I have, or down a drain like I haven't but might one day, then this is what you need, and then you'll be super glad you have it. Some of you will recognize this if you've seen some of my other kits. Is a glue stick, normally associated with a hot glue gun, but you can improvise here using a lighter. Now, care should be taken, but when we apply flame to the glue, it melts into liquid glue, which can then be applied, and then it dries quite quickly after that. And this works with most materials. One of the benefits of the glue stick is that you can produce a decent quantity of glue if needed. And I find this more useful than super glue, which I've found can go off over time, and I feel is generally for smaller jobs. Now, some eagle-eyed viewers will have noticed that this glue stick is thinner than ones I've used before, and that's because this one is 7 millimeters in diameter, and in previous kits, the one I've used is 11 millimeters. Now, the 7 millimeter one is better. It's more compact for a start, but you can control the amount of glue more easily too. And why haven't I mentioned it before? Well, I didn't know it existed until someone mentioned it in the comments in my last kit video. The BIC Mini here makes the glue stick possible, and as mentioned, it's also the most convenient method for producing a flame. Now, that could be for something as simple as lighting candles on a birthday cake at work, or getting a fire going in that holiday cottage you just rented, or lighting that gas hob with the broken igniter. Now, there are other uses too, like say sterilizing a needle before removing a splinter, or melting the ends of some nylon cord to stop it fraying. The list goes on. Next up, we have a Leatherman Micra, a brilliant little scissor-based multi-tool that I've been a fan of for years. And I've had my fair share of these too. These are ones I've lost and subsequently found over the years. The scissors on this are one of the best you can get on a multi-tool, and they are spring-loaded and super capable. Then on one side of the tool, we have a medium flathead screwdriver, a very usable nail file and cleaner, and a small knife for more precision tasks. On the other side, we have a small flathead and another bottle opener, not needed here, and a 2-dimensional Phillips screwdriver and some tweezers. Now, these tweezers are not great, but they are good enough for the odd splinter. Now, don't be put off by the size of this tool. This is a proper Leatherman and can really get stuff done. And as it happens, the Micra was my only EDC knife or tool for many years, long before I'd even heard of EDC. Then we have a flashlight or torch. And for this kit, I chose the Olight i3e. It had to be as small as possible, but still capable of throwing out a decent beam in case you get lost in the dark. Now, this has a single light output of 90 lumens, which can actually light the road ahead. And it needs to be reliable and easy to use. And this is made from aircraft grade aluminium, so it is pretty tough, and it operates with a single twist switch, so no accidental activation. And it's also 100% waterproof. And finally, I wanted something that would take a standard battery for reliability, because with this kit, some content might get ignored for potentially years at a time, and anything that uses a rechargeable battery and electronic switch is likely to see battery depletion over time. On the other hand, a AAA battery like the one in here has a shelf life of up to 10 years. Now, battery life is 45 minutes, can be extended with a nickel metal hydride battery to 70. Either way, not loads, but enough, I feel, in an emergency. Then we have this mini tin for the small stuff. So let me tip everything out so we can see what we have in here. Okay, so we have some medium size safety pins for fixing and fastening. We have two small buttons, a sewing needle and a black and white sewing thread. And this is cannibalized from a sewing kit like this one, selecting just the bare minimum. And in fact, the full sewing kit here would be too big to fit in the tin. And let's face it, six thread color options are probably overkill here. Anyway, I have here an expandable towel that turns into an absorbent cloth when it gets wet, so ideal for mopping up spills and cleaning surfaces or hands and faces. And then in here I have three basic meds that I might need during a day, and they are pain meds, allergy meds, and diarrhea meds. Now, your choice will most likely differ, but do ensure you know what meds are what and the dosages you would need if you've removed them from the packaging. Then I have some flat items in the bottom of the tin, starting with a single banknote for emergencies, and this might feed me or get me home when things go wrong. Also a single prep pad and a couple of band-aids so I can deal with small cuts, and also some write in the rain note paper taken from a pad, but I don't need the whole pad, and this is for use with the pen for jotting things down or leaving notes. And write in the rain paper is more resilient than standard paper. Now, inside here, to stop it getting scratched, I have a flat Fresnel magnifier. This will help me read small print, but more importantly, if I lose my glasses, I can read my phone using this, so I can call people and send and receive messages. And I would normally include thin optics glasses for this, as you might have seen from previous kit videos, but would you believe they are too bulky for this kit. And then here, the last item is very thin and it's called Spartan Fire, and it's described as a multi-use EDC tinder. Now, I included this primarily for use with the Ferro Rod, as it will take a spark, but it can also be used with the lighter when trying to start a fire, as it burns for a long time, which is preferable to using up the lighter gas on a stubborn fire and burning your thumb at the same time. As you can see, nothing is simply chucked in here. Everything has its place. And although size is a priority, I only wanted to include items that are good at what they do and can be relied upon. And as I put everything back, you will see that everything has to go back in a certain way in order for everything to fit. Finally, I've added a decent elastic band, and this of course has a multitude of uses, not least making sure the tin doesn't accidentally open. So I hope that's been useful, and if you want to see my other kit videos, just follow this link here. That's it for this one. Thank you as always for watching. Have a great day, and I hope you can join me in the next one.